画面中的亮点就是中国长征五号运载火箭的残骸。非营利组织 Rachel Telescope 的天文学家马西在意大利拍下了这张照片。这根长30公尺、宽5公尺、重达21吨的火箭舱受到全球关注。美国非营利组织航太公司在官方 Twitter 指出，火箭将在台湾时间9号中午12点19分重返大气层，不过误差值有正负8小时。最新预测指出，中国长征5号 B 运载火箭最快将在台湾时间今晚10点12分和明天清晨5点55分与台湾擦肩而过。但其实这已经不是中共第一次制造太空垃圾。
In 2007, we saw the Chinese conduct a very irresponsible test. We continue to have about 3,000 pieces of debris on orbit that we continue to track. That's about 10% of the total amount of objects that we track on orbit still from that test 14 years ago.
这个月5号，美国太空作战司令部司令怀廷出席众议院军事委员会专门小组听证，两党多位众议员都对中共的反卫星计划表示担忧。
Countries, including China,are developing the capabilities to disable or destroy satellites in space through missiles, other satellites, cyber attacks, or electronic warfare. And as the United States plans our return to the moon, that also raises the importance of minimizing the risk to astronauts in space.
The report identifies China and Russia's anti-satellite weapons program and the threat these programs pose to U.S. terrestrial forces that rely on satellite-based communications.
Yes, we have seen a weaponization of space from China and Russia. If we continue to see the Chinese building satellites like the Shijian 17, which is a Chinese satellite with a robotic arm that could be used to grapple U.S. or allied satellites. We know they have multiple ground laser systems which could blind or damage our satellite systems.
前美国国防情报局局长曾指出，中共拥有多种反卫星武器，包括反卫星导弹、机动卫星、雷射系统和电子干扰器。新唐人亚太电视张启林综合报道。